Good morning, all of you. Today we discuss about the topic phase equilibria for BSc 4 semester class coming under VSK University, Pallar. So, previous class we discuss the phase, component, degrees of freedom, Gibbs phase rule and applications of phase rule in one component system, that is in water system, and application of two component system, that is silver and lead system and potassium iodide and water system. So now the today's class we discussing this the phase equilibria for the two component system. First one is magnesium zinc system and second one is ferric chloride water system. So in magnesium zinc system, it is a two component system which involves the formation of an intermetallic compound, that is magnesium Zn2. So this system has four phases: solid Mg, solid Zn, solid Mg Zn2, and liquid solution of Mg and Zn. So it consists of three curves, that is BC, CDE and AE. That is three curves, BC, CDE and EA, and three areas, that is above BC, above CDA, above AE, and that is eutectic point at C and E. There are two points in C and E, we call it as eutectic points. So last one is congruent melting point is present at O. So that is curve. AE is the freezing point curve of magnesium. It shows that the melting point of magnesium 650 degrees centigrade is lowered on the addition of zinc. This continues until point E is reached. Here the new phase of solid magnesium Zn2 appears. So next one is ED. ED shows the increase of concentration of zinc in the melt with the rise of temperature. At D, the composition of melt and the solid compound becomes the same, that is magnesium Zn2. Hence, D represents the melting point magnesium Mg Zn2, that is 590 degrees centigrade. So the curve DC shows that the lowering of the melting point with the addition of zinc until the lowest point is attained. Here solid Zn appears. So the curve BC exhibits the melting point of zinc, that is 419 degrees centigrade, falls with the addition of magnesium until the point C is reached. So there are two phases in this equilibrium, that is one is solid phase, that is magnesium, zinc, MgZn2, and other one is liquid phase. Hence there are two phases. Next, applying reduced phase rule, we have F is equal to C minus P plus 1 is equals to 2, there is a two component system, minus P minus 2, two phases, plus 1 is equals to 1. This shows that the system Mg liquid, Zn and liquid, and Mg Zn2 liquid are all monovariant. So there are three areas. First one is above BC, above CDA and above AE. The area above curves BC, CDE and AE represent the solution of magnesium and zinc. The single phase system at any point in this area is bivariant. Okay. So next point is eutectic point in C and E. There are two eutectic points in C and E. And phases present at C are solid zinc, solid MgZn2 and liquid. And phases present in E is solid Mg, solid magnesium, solid MgZn2 and liquid. Hence, the applying reduced phase rule in this eutectic points, we get F is equals to C minus P plus 1, that is equals to 2 minus 3 plus 1 is equals to 0. Hence, these two eutectic points are non-variant. So, last point is congruent melting point. So, the composition of the compound is MgZn2 and the melt at D is identical. The corresponding temperature is the congruent melting point of the compound. Here the system has two phases, one is solid compound and another one is melt. Both these can be represented by one component, that is magnesium Zn2, MgZn2. Hence there are the system D is non-variant. So applying the reduced phase rule, we get F is equals to C minus P plus 1, that equals to 1 minus 2 plus 1 is equals to 0. Hence, the congruent point melting point at D is non-variant. So, this is the phase equilibrium for the magnesium and zinc system. So, next one is ferric chloride and water system. Ferric chloride and water system. So, this system has two component system. One is Fe2Cl6 ferric chloride and another one is water H2. It has seven phase condensed systems. So one first one is Fe2Cl6 12H2O and Fe2Cl6 7H2O and Fe2Cl6 5H2O and Fe2Cl6 4H2O and fourth one is and fifth one anhydrous ferric chloride and seventh one the solution. So there are the curve here, the curve is LM, L is freezing point of water. So the curve LM shows the lowering of freezing point and the addition of ferric chloride, hence is named as the freezing point curve of water. Hence the curve LM is named as freezing point curve of water. Next one is the freezing point falls till the point M is reached where the new phases, that is Fe2Cl6 12H2O, separates. Now temperature is raised and more Fe2Cl6 is added, the curve LMN is formed and saturated solution are in equilibrium along this curve. Hence, it is called the solubility curve of dodecahydrate. So, the curve LMN is the solubility curve of dodecahydrate, that is Fe2Cl6 12H2. Then, the solubility curve MNO, MNO, this curve is the solubility curve at 12H2O terminates at O where another 7H2O separates. The curve OPQ is the solubility curve of heptahydrate, at Q the 5H2O appears and QRS is its solubility. At S, 4H2O separates and curve STU is its solubility curve. At U, solid ferric chloride, that is Fe2Cl6, appears and the curve UV is the solubility curve of the anhydrous salt. Along the curve, LM, MNO, OPQ, QRS, STU and UV, one solid phase and one liquid phase are in equilibrium. So applying the reduced phase rule in this curve, we get F is equals to C minus P plus 1, that equals to 2 minus 2 plus 1, that is equals to 1. Hence the curves all are monovariant. So next one is the congruent melting point. At point NPRT, so above the curve, the composition of solution in equilibrium with respect to hydrate is identical. Hence, these points are called congruent melting points. It has two phases and one component systems. The congruent melting point has two phases and one component system. Applying reduced phase rule, that is F is equals to C minus P plus 1, that equals to 1 minus 2 plus 1, that is equals to 0. Hence, the congruent melting points are non-variant. So at N, 12H2O congruent melting point is 37 degree centigrade. At P, 7H2O congruent melting point is, that is 32.5 degree centigrade. At G, 5H2O a congruent melting point is 56 degree centigrade. At I, 4H2O a congruent melting point is 73.5 degree centigrade. So last one is the eutectic points. There are 5 eutectic points in this phase diagram, that is M, O, Q, S, U. M, O, Q, S, U below the curves. So at P, I's here, the phases are, 3 phases are present, that is I's, 12H2O and the solution at temperature is minus 55 degree centigrade. At O, that is at first one is at M. So second one is at O, the phases are 12H2O, 7H2O and solution, 3 phases, and the temperature is, the eutectic point is 27.4 degree centigrade. At O, at Q, the phases are 7H2O, 5H2O and solution, they are in equilibrium and the temperature, eutectic point is 30 degree centigrade. At S, 5H2O, 4H2O and solution, and the eutectic temperature is 55 degree centigrade. And last one at U, 4H2O and ferric chloride FeCl6 and solution. So the eutectic temperature is 66 degree centigrade. So it has 3 phases. So this eutectic points has 3 phases and 2 component system. Hence, applying reduced phase rule, we get F is equals to C minus P plus 1, that is equals to 2 minus 3 plus 1 is equals to 0. So these are non-variant. Hence, this completes the ferric chloride and water system as well as magnesium and zinc system. Thank you.